We are beginning tonight with Isaac, now a tropical storm, continuing to batter the Gulf Coast with strong winds and rain. People from Louisiana to Mississippi dealing with flooding tonight, and hundreds of thousands are without power.
Storm may be getting weaker, but it's still packing a punch and just pummeling the area. Despite the damage, though, emergency personnel say New Orleans has held its ground against Isaac.
Meantime, this morning, the mayor of New Orleans issued a dusk-to-dawn curfew for the city that was lashed by Isaac on the 7th anniversary of Hurricane Katrina. Sadly, familiar scenes for some. The Louisiana National Guard rescuing dozens of people today after water topped the levees, protecting Plaquemines Parish. Just a short time ago, state leaders announced that they will have to breach an 18-mile levee in that area to relieve pressure caused by floodwaters.
House started flooding in. We just got out the back door with the boat, tried to save my next-door neighbors, which couldn't happen. But the wind was so strong, it was pushing the boat the opposite way.
Well, this is a photo showing just how high the water got in Plaquemines Parish. This is the Orleans Marina flooded out. Army Corps of Engineers says flood protection system is holding up in New Orleans proper, but they're still on high alert tonight.
And, of course, it's not just Louisiana getting hard hit. This is Past Christian, Mississippi, which was also hit hard during Katrina. It's getting its fair share of heavy winds and, of course, a ton of rain. Dozens of dogs, cats, and other pets were among those ferried out of one of the flooded areas today. And it's difficult to think of Isaac without conjuring up memories of Katrina and the thousands of victims whose lives were forever altered by that experience. Not only people, but pets as well. Action News reporter Jacqueline Mazur caught up with some Central Coast pet owners who adopted some of the dogs rescued during Katrina. Jacqueline?
That's right, Erin. And as you know, Katrina came in and wiped out buildings and lives. Among them are four-legged friends. But thankfully, with help from the SPCA, some animals did make it out safely, and they have new homes. We caught up with two owners today to share their story. This is 8-year-old Foxy. And this is 10-year-old Harley. Two seemingly normal mutts today that harbor a not-so-normal past.
He was heartworm positive. He was not fixed. And I think he lived on the streets for a while.
They told me that they had found her floating on a tire or some kind of sort of floating apparatus.
Foxy and Harley are survivors. During the wake of Hurricane Katrina, these mutts made it out alive.
I thought that was a wonderful thing that the SPCA did.
The SPCA for Monterey County took in dozens of canines, hoping to reunite them with their families or find them new ones.
My son said that they went actually four times to the SPCA to pick the correct dog, which they thought would be a companion. And this one kept looking at them and kept looking at them, and my son said, that's the dog.
So Foxy finally made it home, and so did Harley, two very lucky mutts that have since then adapted quite well.
I call him a little punk. He, you know, take advantage of little kids, take their food.
Yeah, he's like your kid's best.
And there are many more success stories about dogs that were rescued from the SPCA during the horrible wake of the Katrina aftermath. Now, SPCA staff do tell us they were able actually to reunite some pets with their previous owners. The ones who didn't get reunited, however, like Foxy and Harley, do have new homes all to themselves. Erin.
All right. Thank you, Jacqueline. In all, the SPCA took in 31 dogs during Katrina, actually reunited 18 pets with their original owners, and they actually won an honor for that. They were rated the top shelter in the country for their ability to reunite pets with their owners.
Those who remember Katrina say it left a remarkable path of destruction. This is amateur video of the aftermath from a Pebble Beach man who moved here after Katrina from Biloxi, Mississippi. Wallace Walker recounted the nightmare with us. He says that it's very difficult for most people to understand the power of Mother Nature until they witness the destruction. As for Hurricane Isaac, Walker has some advice for people there.
Patience. A lot of patience, because there's the workers, they're doing everything they can to get the power restored, getting everything restored and trying to get the cleanup done and trying to get the grocery stores restocked and There's a lot of things going on, and it takes a lot of patience to get all this stuff done.
Walker says he was not in fear for his life, but says the roof of his apartment caved in during Katrina. Also says he was actually one of the lucky ones. Meantime, a Central Coast man and his daughter are right in the middle of Isaac. Santa Cruz County Superior Court's executive officer, Alex Calvo, has been stranded in New Orleans for the past couple of days with his daughter, a student at Tulane. They're safe, holed up in a hotel right along the Mississippi River tonight.
Yeah, we've seen some street flooding, and outside of our window, we saw that there's some flagpoles that have been knocked over and some light poles that have been broken out. And then just watching the local news, we know that there's a lot of trees down up in the neighborhoods.
Well, Alex Calvo is hoping he can leave by maybe Friday, and his daughter can return to Tulane on the campus as soon as it's safe. Well, what is now Tropical Storm Isaac is continuing to plow north, and Jim will have more on its path coming up. You can also check on its progress anytime on our website at ksbw.com.